Okay, in today's video we are going to discuss your taxonomic category, taxonomic hierarchy. Okay, now this represents your taxonomic category in hierarchical arrangement in ascending order. Okay, मैंने आपको बोला था previous video में each level, okay, each level represents as your category. Category को आप दूसरा क्या बोल सकते हो? Yes, rank, or you can say as your taxon one and the same. All these taxonomic categories together constitutes your taxonomic hierarchy. And जैसे कि मैंने बोला था, there are total 7 taxonomic categories that we have to study in detail. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Okay, ये सारी taxonomic category है, मिलजुल के they are responsible in forming taxonomic hierarchy, and this is the ascending arrangement. Now, if you are talking about taxonomic hierarchy, right, then सबसे lowest category is of your species. Lowest category is of your species, and सबसे ऊपर, as you can see over here, the topmost category is your kingdom. Kingdom in the sense we are talking about your plant kingdom and animal kingdom in general. तो सबसे lowermost, सबसे bottom पे जो category है is your species, and the top one represents your kingdom, right? Now these are your category, and this is the way you can memorize it. Okay, kids prefer chocolate over fried green spinach. Very simple it is. Kids prefer chocolate over fried green spinach. जहाँ पे K stands for your kingdom, P for your phylum. Okay, for animals we will say this category as phylum. But if we are talking about plants, then it is represented as your division. Okay, so if I am using the term phylum, we are using what? Animals. If I am using word division, we are describing plants, right? So P stands for your phylum, then C stands for your class, O stands for order, F stands for family, G stands for genus, and S stands for species. So this is simple way to memorize this taxonomic hierarchy. Once again, what is the way? Kids prefer chocolate over fried green spinach. Abbreviation आपको याद रखना है, kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus, and your species. Okay, you have to remember species is at bottom, lowest category in your taxonomic hierarchy. Now we are going to describe each of this category one by one. Okay, students, now we are going to start with your lowest category of our taxonomic hierarchy, that is our species. Now you people are familiar with the word species, right? Species ka matlab kya hota hai? It is nothing but group of organisms who shares fundamental characters, whose fundamental characters are same, right? That constitutes your species. Okay, so what is species? A group of organism with fundamental similarities, most important thing, right? Having fundamental similarities, this constitutes your species. As such, species is called as building brick of biological classification. ये आपको याद रखना है, species is called as your building brick in biological classification, and you very well know that it constitutes your lowest category of hierarchy. Once again, species क्या होता है? The organism who shares fundamental similarities, right? This constitutes your species. Now some example I have written. We people have understood your binomial nomenclature, right? What is binomial nomenclature? Where one particular organism have two name, one represents your genus and another represents your species. So here I have written some of your scientific name, right? One such of your mango is Mangifera indica. We should remember rules of writing your scientific name when we are writing, right? Handwritten, it should be separately underlined. Genus ka first word kaisa hona chahiye? Capital. And if you are talking about your species, it begins with your small letter. So whenever you are writing scientific name, you have to take care of this. You have to separately underline. Otherwise, it will become wrong. Okay. So first I have written of your mango. What is the scientific name of mango? That is your Mangifera indica. Where Mangifera indicates your genus. Aapko pata hai. And indica is our species, that is your specific epithet or specific name. Okay, now second example I have written, that is of your potato. The scientific name of potato is Solanum tuberosum. Okay, this forms your, this comes under your potato family, right? Solanum tuberosum, where Solanum stands for your genus and tuberosum represents your species. Okay, so one must identify this difference between two species on the basis of morphological difference. Simple as that. Aapko pata hona chahiye, what is the morphological difference between mango and potato? Okay, if I am talking about morphological difference, morphology ka matlab hota hai external appearance. Externally, आपको differentiate करना आना चाहिए, right? Now, here lion, lion का scientific name है Panthera leo. Again, this is your genus and this is your species. I have written of your tiger, that is your Panthera tigris. Even I have written of your leopard, that is our Panthera pardus. Okay, ये scientific name आपको याद रखने हैं. Once again, this first one represents your genus, which forms your next higher taxonomic category, right? And all this thing indicates species. Species kya hai beta ji? Group of your organism have fundamental similarities, who have fundamental similarity. Okay, now if we are talking about one particular genus, जैसे कि यहाँ पे देखो एक ही genus है Panthera, Panthera, Panthera. So what I am trying to say over here that one particular genus may have different species. Important thing ये आपको याद रखना है. एक genus may have more than one species. जैसे कि if you are talking about this genus Panthera. तो पेंथेरा के अंदर क्या क्या चीज आएगी आपकी? लायन, टाइगर एंड लेपर्ड, दैट इज योर लियो, टाइग्रिस एज वेल एज पार्डस. सिंपल एज दैट. ओके, मैंने आपको ये बोला कि वन जीनस मे कंटेन मोर देन वन स्पीशीज. एन एग्जाम्पल फॉर द सेम इज हियर, द जीनस पेंथेरा, द जीनस पेंथेरा कंटेन्स योर व्हाट? लायन, tiger as well as your leopard. Okay, so all these three species shares a common genus, that is your Panthera. So this is about your species. Okay, as we move upward in taxonomic hierarchy, after your species comes your genus. So now let's talk about genus. What is genus? Genus are nothing than aggregates of species, again, who have some common characters. So what I have written in second point, genera are aggregates of closely related species. Okay? So closely related species hoti hai. This all comes together and constitutes one genus. Again, what I have written, genus comprises of group of related species which has more characters in common in comparison to species of other genera. Okay, so very simple as that. Species which are closely related, which are closely associated, they comes together and forms your genus. Okay, in species I have told, one such example I have mentioned, that is of your Panthera. That is of your Panthera. Panthera kya hai yahan pe aapka? Genus. This genus have three species, as this three lion, tiger, and leopard share some common characters, so they are placed together in one genus called as Panthera. So we have seen Panthera leo, Panthera tigris, and Panthera pardus. Okay, so this is very simple. One another example related to your plants, we have understood your Solanum tuberosum, yes or no, where Solanum represents your genus and tuberosum represents your species. Conscious species of potato. Now look, if you are talking about your potato, tomato, and brinjal, these three species are closely related in comparison to some other species, right? So these three species are grouped together in one genus, that is your Solanum. So again, Solanum tuberosum, Solanum lycopodium. Solanum lycopodium is scientific name for your tomato. What is scientific name for your brinjal? Is your Solanum melongena. The scientific name for brinjal, that is our egg plant, is Solanum melongena. Okay, so these three species, that is your tuberosum, lycopodium, and melongena, shares common characters. They are closely related with each other, so they are placed in a common genus, that is our Solanum. That is our Solanum. Okay, one thing I want to write over here, there is genus called as Felis, genus called as Felis, which contains cat. Okay, so your genus Felis kiska hai? Cat ka. And genus Panthera kiska hai? Lion, tiger, and leopard. These two are different thing. Okay, वापस एक बार आपको क्या याद रखना है, genus क्या कहलाता है? It is nothing but group of closely related species. Okay, so if the species of cat are placed in genus Felis, whereas species of lion, tiger, and leopard are placed in genus Panthera. The scientific name यहाँ पे आपको याद रखना है, Solanum lycopodium of tomato and Solanum melongena of your brinjal. Otherwise, it is also called as your egg plant. इसको आप क्या बोलो? Egg plant. One and the same. So this is all about your genus. Okay. Next taxonomic category that we are going to discuss is of our family. Okay, we have understood your species, group of species forms your genus, to be more specific, closely related one. Now, group of this genus constitutes your family. Okay, so what I have written, family is group of related genera with less number of similarities as that of genus and species. Okay, now one example I have written over here. If you are talking about your genus Solanum, we are talking about your genus Petuna. Here I have written genus Datura. These three are different genus. Okay, we very well know that this is genus of your potato, tomato, and brinjal. Okay, so here potato, tomato, and your brinjal constitutes your genus, that is your Solanum. Now if you are talking about genus Petuna, again it includes some flowering plant. If we are talking about genus Datura, this includes your poisonous flowering plants which are active at evening. They are also called as devil's trumpet. उसको क्या बोला जाता है? Devil trumpet. Now, this three genus, Solanum plus Petuna plus Datura, which are related to each other, even though similarities are less in comparison to genus and species, They are placed in a common family called as Solanaceae. So simple as that. Solanaceae क्या है? Solanaceae is combo pack of three genus. That is your genus Solanum, genus Petuna, and your genus Datura. Okay. Now one thing you have to memorize that as we are going from lower portion to upper portion, from bottom to top, similarities जो होती है, it will decreases. Similarity will decreases. Simple as that. अगर आप ऊपर से नीचे आओ तो क्या होगा? क्या होगा? Similarity will increases. But if you are going from bottom to top, that is from species to kingdom, similarities will decrease and dissimilarity will increase. Okay. So, यहाँ पे definition में क्या लिखा है मैंने? Families are related genera, of course. But they are having less number of similarities in comparison to genus and species. Now see, look, there is no relationship between tomato and this is your Datura. However, due to some kind of relation, due to some similarity, they are placed together in a common family called as your Solanaceae. Okay, so this is about your plant. If you are talking about animals, we have understood your genus Panthera. Again, genus Panthera includes your कौन सी species? Lion, tiger, leopard, जो हमने पढ़ा. This is your genus Felis. Genus Felis includes कौन सी one? कौन सी species? Cat. Okay. Your genus Felis includes your cat. This includes your lion, tiger, and your leopard. Yes or no? Yes. Due to some similarities, due to some relationship, they are placed together in a family called as Felidae. In a family called as Felidae. So once again, what is family Felidae? Felidae is combo pack of your Panthera and Felis. Panthera, which includes lion, tiger, leopard, which are roaring one. And your Felis includes your cat, which is non-roaring animal. Okay. But due to some kind of relationship between them, they are placed together in a family called as your Felidae. So, this is your family Solanaceae and this is your family Felidae. Okay, for ease of your understanding, here I have drawn a flowchart, right? Once again, what is family? Families are nothing but related genera, right? Now we are talking about two genus. Look, I have written that is your genus Canis and genus Vulx. Okay, these two are the name of genus. Now let's talk about what this genus Canis includes. This genus includes your dog, includes your wolf and your jackal. Okay, see, some examples I have written over here for your explanation only. Okay, it includes many more also, but for your understanding I have only written three. Your Canis genus, ye jo genus Canis hai, it includes your dog, wolf and jackal. Whereas if we are talking about your genus Vulx, right, so this genus includes your fox. And here I have written the scientific name which must be underlined, right? So what is scientific name of dog? Canis familiaris. For your wolf is Canis lupus. For your jackal is Canis aurens. So ye kya hogi bitte beta ji aapki species, right? One closely related species are placed in one genus, right? So all these three species have a common genus called as Canis. Simple as that. Now let's talk about that Vulx, right? Fox ka scientific name kya hai? Vulx, Vulx. Maine aapko bola tha ki rarely the generic name and specific name are same. And that is called as? Usko kya kaha jata hai? Totonyms. Usko kaha jata hai totonym. So here is one example of your totonym. Aage humne kya kara tha your? कुछ एग्जाम्पल्स बोले थे मैंने आपको, मेमोराइज दैट. ओके, सो दिस इज एग्जाम्पल ऑफ योर टॉटोनिम. कम बैक टू दिस पॉइंट. सो दिस कैनिस इंक्लूड्स योर डॉग, वुल्फ, जैकल. योर वुल्फ्स इंक्लूड्स योर फॉक्स. नाउ दिस टू जीनस आर क्लोजली related with each other and hence placed in a common family, that is your Canidae. So what Canidae includes? Canidae includes your genus Canis as well as your wolves. Simple si baat hai, okay? So this is description about your family. I hope you people understood. Simple is that species, right? Group of related species forms your genus. Group of related genus forms your family. And ek cheez jo aapko yaad rakhni hai, moving from bottom to top similarities always decreases and decreases. Okay?